listen close. Well, once again, y'all, I hope you enjoyed this conversation, because this was deep. But I didn't expect it to go here. But that's the dope part about understanding creative people. You may think you're going somewhere, but it'll take you a whole nother way when you come from truth and you come from your heart. So before we go, I'm not doing any rapid fires because this is an album-specific interview. If you want them to get in contact with you, can you drop your social media, please?
Ghetto Campbell on Facebook. Gail_Campbell01 on Instagram. Gail Camp on Twitter. I think that's it.
No, I'm not on Twitter like that.
You know, I'm there.
Stanley Ipkiss, Facebook. King Ipkiss 26 on Instagram.
Gail Campbell on YouTube.
Oh, definitely. Bloody Waters video out right now.
Yes.
Make sure you go see that. It's on heritagehiphop.com on our video page. And also, you have Gail Campbell's YouTube page specifically if you want to see more of her and her work. Now, instead of doing a rapid fire, I want to do an inflection. I want to know what this means to you. We had a song that I thought was titled That's a Man. But what is the title of the song?
It's too bad.
Okay. A ladylike attitude in the blues. What does that mean to you?
Ladylike attitude in the blues. I think of first thing came to mind because of What a Man. We got the video in our head. I thought of Suge Avery, who was a fictional character.
That was the first thing.
She's a fictional character, but she's so real to me. Yes. So that's
I'm dancing behind the camera because she did this crazy.
The day she recorded it, she was recording it. I was on live with my wife. I was like, it reminds me of that scene where she was singing to her father's church, and I wanted that to be the video for it.
Okay. All right. As I kind of said before, and I think you heard me say this, when Gail sings, it's very color purple, soul-filled music. From Sister, You've Been on My Mind, to God's Trying to Tell You Something. And it's very, very impactful.
I couldn't sleep that night.
I can't lie to you, I hate the color purple. I think it's one of the worst movies I've ever seen in my life.
I love it.
But the music part, and that one part, gives me goosebumps.
Quincy
Jones. That's
the
realest part of the movie. Because when somebody sings from their heart and they give it all out to you, you cannot deny that message. Mm-hmm. And that's what I get from your music. Mm. I'm not into Mr. and sleeping with sister. Look, that, I ain't into all that. Beating up your husband and laughing at Thanksgiving and spitting in tea. Like, I'm not into that. That's not my thing. But when they're at the juke joint and then she hears the gospel, mm-hmm, and it switches, mm-hmm, and it's like, here it is, the two dichotomies of life. No matter how you look at it,
sin has got
from
souls.
The world to the pulpit. And what was the one thing she said when she got there? I love you, Daddy. And that was the thing that made that scene powerful. Because while she's coming into her emotions, people are dancing and going crazy. But while the world is frantic, love is still and it holds you down. Mm-hmm. And that's what I got from you singing. Mm. So here's the next part I want to ask you. Inflection. When I said the voice of the piano and the love clash, what does that mean to you?
The voice of the piano and the love clash.
I take it for a loss of words. Heritage Hip Hop is back on top.
Yeah, I am. I really am a loss of words for that. Again, when I do the music, I don't think, I don't know anything. Like, when I go back and listen to it, I'm an outsider now. So it was like, I didn't do it for a purpose. I don't know exactly what it means when I do it until someone like her gets on and explained it to me. So, Yeah, I can't explain that.
Can I have something to say about that? Okay. I'm thinking about something that that sis said, his wife. She said, like, the love relationship is between you and him and his music. Mm-hmm. And she had to get used to that when they got together. She had to know that his music, you know, like, his music is his love, and that she needed to make it her love in order to be in a relationship with him. So that's what I was thinking, like, the man at the piano and the love clash.
I don't know. I mean, I think everybody has their own perception or interpretation of it.
Of course, that's why I wanted yours, because when I started the voice and the piano, like I said, every instrument's job is not to give sounds, to give emotion. Mm-hmm. So the piano speak, like, piano is my favorite instrument by far. But when you hear of the love clash, see, in music, the clash is like a DJ battle. Mm-hmm. That's when both of the speakers come out. You got to play your sound, and that's the clash. Mm-hmm. So people rocking over here, and they stop, and they rock over here, and the clash is who's going to win the crowd. But love pulls you in different ways that way, too. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could love your charm, but not really love how you speak. I could love how you make me feel, but can't always love being around you. Mm-hmm. So it's a struggle there. It kind of pulls you, you know, apart. Another one I want to ask, reflection and reflection, don't know love, sacrifice and being unappreciated. You can give your all to someone because love is sacrifice and still not feel like that person really understands how great your love is, and you call it blasphemy. And the blaspheme is to take for granted the higher spiritual things that are apparent in front of you. Mm-hmm. What does blasphemy in music entail to you? You kind of spoke on it already, but I want to get you seeing a little different light, where you say you take this serious now. It's not like something that you just do, I sound good, whatever. That this is real for you. And for someone not to really take their gift serious is blasphemy. Mm. And you said that and you said that when you sing your things out, it comes a little different. I remember it being written that God said, if you don't believe me, test me. Do what I say, do, and see if I don't bless you. Mm-hmm. And it's like, if I gave you this, how dare you not use it so I can bless you with it? The man with the talents, you buried your talent, you lazy servant. You didn't even do what good I gave you to do good with. But the person who had a little, I'll give him more, because not only did he did good with it, but he brought others to it. What does that blasphemy of people who don't use that talent or their music to do something mean to you?
I think that I don't subscribe to fear anymore, but when I did, the main thing that I feared in life was being mediocre. I did not want to, because I know that I felt things inside of me, and I know that everyone around me saw things in me, and my fear was being not living up to that potential. And so for me, I don't feel that way anymore. I just do everything I want to do now. But for those who bury their talents for whatever reason, fear or what have you, I would say, think about on your deathbed, and thinking about everything that you didn't do for whatever reason, every excuse you gave yourself, fear or, you know, doubt or whatever. How are you gonna feel? And, you know, and I think about my mom a lot. You know, my mother is alive and well or whatever, but my mother is an amazing singer. Like, could have been a really, really big star. My mother sings for her own enjoyment now, but I know that my mother feel like, you know what, I wanted to do this and I wanted to do that, but she, you know, she chose motherhood and everything else. that's something I don't want. I want to get everything out. And, you know, I think about, I heard something, Les Brown was like, all the gifts, you find all the gifts in the world in the cemetery. All the gifts in the world in the cemetery, and they're yelling at you saying, you never gave us life. We could have did this, we could have did that. So, late in life, I'm no spring chicken, but I decided, like, I'm not going to, as long as God gives me breath, I'm going to do everything that he puts in my heart and mind to do. And he'll give me the strength and the resources and everything to do it. When I look at young artists who I see the same thing in, I'm fearful for them. I see their fear, I see their excuses, I see their doubt, and I just don't want them to do that. And actually, people tell me, they reach out to me and tell me that I inspired them to go and do stuff. So, you know, God be praised for that.
That's what's up. And we want everybody to be inspired to pick up the album. When is the album dropping?
March 30th as of now. Right. Definitely
around the same time. 3/26 is going
to
drop.
Oh, so it's going to be a double whammy.
Mm-hmm. Bam! Bam!
And Epic is the Gail Campbell trying to go for Artist of the Year for Heritage Hip Hop next year.
Trying.
I put that out there last
trying.
Year.
Trying.
Yeah, he said album of the year.
We already know. We already know. Wait till you hear the new joint.
I want the album.
You got
no more slices of pie. I want to put my face in. I'm good. You know what I'm saying? But to everybody out there that's watching this, thank you for watching. Understand that Heritage Hip Hop is not about exposing new beats and just this song. It's about exposing the artist so you get an understanding of the realness that comes from them and when they make their art. Everybody has a voice. Everybody should be heard. Everybody has a right to be taught and to teach. And we thank you for letting us bring you into our lives and into the majesty of Gail Campbell and Stan Ipkiss. Peace, and may the Most High bless y'all.
I got a fire down in my soul, and you saw it from a mile away. You wanna come and enjoy this heat, huh? You wanna have it every night and day, but you're like a viper, you're fighter. You wanna rewrite every side and squeeze it tighter. Baby, just enjoy me. It's like a game of shame. You like my pain, it's insane, but you won't destroy me. Coming around me, you keep on coming around me. Your kisses deadly, you sought me out and then you found me. You keep on coming around me, why you keep trying to bound me? But you won't destroy me. Oh.